A jaw-dropping moment. A Banksy painting sells at auction for $1.4 million. The gavel drops, and so does the painting.
That's selling for $860.
So what happened in that moment? A painting is shredded? Yep, that's what you saw. Joining me now, someone who knows the elusive artist Banksy and his work very well, Steve Lazaridis, once represented Banksy and was the first seller of his art. Good to have you with us. I'd just love to get your take, first of all, on that moment and what we saw as soon as that painting sold for $1.4 million, half of it is shredded.
Hey, Erica. Well, I think it's probably one of the finest moments in auction history. Aside from the Da Vinci selling for that ridiculous amount of money last year, this will go down in history as one of the craziest auction moments of all time, I think. I think it's probably one of the best stunts Banksy's ever done.
So one of the best, stunts. Look at this as art or publicity or a stunt? You look at this as what happened, what we saw as art.
I think it's a little bit of everything, to be honest. I think you could have it down as performance art, you could have it down as a stunt, and it reminds me of the old stunts he used to pull off when he was putting old masters up in places like the Tate Britain and putting stuff in various museums around the world. I think it's a return to it's a tour de force for him, I think. And I think you can interpret it in many different ways. I'm unsure whether I think the painting's going to be more valuable or less valuable, but it's definitely going to be the most famous Banksy painting in history.
Who is he? I mean, because of your history, can you give us any more insight into who Banksy really is?
No, because that would be like telling a five-year-old child that Santa Claus doesn't exist.
Hey, listen, go spreading that on this program.
I'll try and stop. No, I'm not giving anything away. I've hidden it all these years. I'm not going to give it away now. I think, you know, that's part and parcel of who he is.
Did any of that surprise you, though, what we just saw?
No, not really. It's, you know, that's the kind of his meticulous planning, the humor, the thumbing his nose at the kind of establishment. And I think, you know, part of it was a commentary on the prices his works are now starting to realize. You have to remember that one of those Girl in Bloom pieces back in 2006 when they were made, he didn't even call them canvases. At the time, they were called street souvenirs. We used to sell them at a event we did called Santa's Ghetto, and they sold for 250 quid. So that piece you saw selling for a million was originally sold for £250. So I think part of it is a commentary on, you know, the crazy state of his of how much his paintings are going for nowadays.
I'm told that, so you're at your gallery right now, over your shoulder. You're a little small on my screen, but...
There's one over there.
Well, yeah. So tell me about that piece.
The Girl in Bloom piece or the other piece?
No, the one right behind you.
I can't tell which one's behind
me. Oh, you can't see it.
the Monet with the well. So that piece, he did a whole series of paintings called Crude Oils. So we did a show in West London many years ago where we took over a shop. It had about 25 of these paintings in, which he called Corrupted Oil Paintings. And at the same time, it had 200 live rats running around in the show. And people would queue for hours to get into the exhibition, walk around with the rats, and then get kicked out after 2 minutes to let the next person in. And then the Corrupted Oils became probably the most desirable of his paintings for quite a long time, until that was superseded by the Girl in Bloom.
What are you hearing in the art community about this latest stunt? Publicity stunt, performance art, as you said, you could interpret it in a number of different ways.
Yeah, I think, you know, there's various different theories that come out over the weekend. There was one that Sotheby's were in collusion with him, which I find, you know, having known him for many years and knowing how anti-establishment he is and how corporate someone like Sotheby's is, I think it's very, very unlikely that there was any kind of collusion. And I think many people in the art world think this is a you know, a brilliant, brilliant piece of performance art by him. And it's, you know, it's rare that you see something that's not been done before. And this is definitely something that's not been done in an auction house before. Maybe it will start a trend where people are shredding their paintings.
It just might. That is a chance, although, you know, first one will probably be the most important one.
Yeah, I'd quite like to see a Rothko go up and then suddenly get shredded. I think that might cause an uproar, but I think he'll be the first and only person to have ever done it.
Yeah, I think it sounds that way. That's a lot of money to see shredded. Steve Lazaridis, appreciate you joining us. Thank you. And listen, whenever you want to reveal some more details, we're here.
Okay, brilliant. Thanks, Derek.
Thanks.
Bye.